Welcome to the experiential activity. So children, in the last activity, we have learned how to make a true solution and suspension. So today we are going to observe different properties of these two solutions, that is true solution and suspension. So let's start with our first activity. That is, first of all, we are going to see these two solutions, suspension and true solution, are they transparent or not? So children, it's going to be very clear to you. It's a true solution which we have made by dissolving sodium chloride into water. You can see this is transparent. That is why we say true solution is a homogeneous mixture, as well as true solution is always transparent. Transparent, you all know, we can see through it. And if we are going to take our next solution, that is the suspension that we have made with the help of calcium carbonate and water, children, you can see this is not transparent, rather it is opaque. We are unable to see through it from one side to another, it's opaque. So this is the property of suspension, that it is opaque, and this is the property of true solution, that it is transparent. So now let's talk about another properties, that is the filtration criteria. If we see, if we want to filter, first of all, the true solution, if we are going to filter from the filtration, just see in the filtration apparatus, I have just fixed this filter paper and I'm going to filter it, and let's see what happens. We are just going to filter the true solution from the filter paper, and let's see children what happens. You are able to see the filtrate which has come down is very clear. And if we are going to check the filter paper above it, let me show you. There is no residue left on the filter paper. So this is the property of a true solution, that we cannot separate sodium chloride from water, that is solute from solvent, cannot be separated by simple filtration. Now let's filter the suspension, children. Let us see what happens now. We are going to filter suspension. It will take time because here calcium carbonate is not fully dissolved. Let us see what happens here. So now children, let's see what has happened in case of suspension when we have filtered suspension. You can see when we have filtered suspension, this filtrate is clear. Now we have to check for the residue left on the filter paper. Let us see. Yes, see children, this filter paper here is not clear. Residue is there. So this is very clear now from this filtration process. Then when we are going to filter true solution, we cannot separate the components of true solution with the filter paper technique or filtration technique. And in case of suspension, we are able to do so. So now let's study our third property, that is stability. See children, you are able to see here, we have these two solutions made. This is true solution and this is suspension. To distinguish also, I have taken two different beakers to make you people understand. See children, I have not touched this true solution from the last 10-15 minutes or so, and we are able to see the same condition of the true solution. So this is a stable solution. Now let's check for the suspension. I hope children it's visible to you. You are able to see that in case of suspension, these particles, chalk powder, that is calcium carbonate, is settled at the bottom. So this solution in chemistry we call it as unstable solution. So I hope children this activity is clear to you. How are we going to distinguish between true solution and suspension on the basis of filterability as well as on the stability criteria.
Thank you, Shemstars. That's all for today. You can drop your queries if you have any on the Google Classroom. Take care. God bless you all.